Today's tutorial is all about my two favorite things, blending with oil pastels and cupcakes. Oil pastels are the perfect materials for making artworks about food. They're thick, they're rich, they're velvety, and you can layer colors that just pops off your page. This tutorial will show you how to blend food colors to create more than one cupcake that looks so realistic you want to eat it right off the page. First, I'll show you step-by-step how to draw your cupcake. Then we'll practice mixing and blending oil pastel colors to create a 3D effect for whatever you want to draw. Then we'll go through one cupcake, and then we'll do a second one on a decorative piece of paper a little bit faster. If you love art, don't forget to subscribe so you can get a weekly art tutorial from an art teacher. The first step is drawing out our cupcake with a pencil. Start with a slightly curved line, and then add two slightly diagonal lines off to the side. Then you're gonna copy that first curved line, and then you're gonna mirror image it on the top. Time for icing. I do three organic shapes that go from bigger to smaller, and the top shape I always want to have like a little point, like a Hershey kiss. You can change the shape of your icing, you can make your icing have little lines in it, but for today I'm trying to do a simple cupcake that focuses more on the blending of oil pastels. Now I'm adding a zigzag line so it looks like my cupcake was in a wrapper. Like an accordion, you will then add a line that connects the top and bottom of each of your zigzags from each point. This will make your cupcake look even more interesting as you add color. Now for my favorite part, color blending. I will show you how to do a series of color gradients from dark to light, so whatever you want your cupcake to look like, you have the skills to make it look 3D. So for a vanilla cupcake, you're gonna start with a dark brown, and then you're going to mix it with a yellow ochre. When you blend colors, they aren't separate from each other, but you want to go back and make sure it goes from dark to light. The trick is if you want one color more dominant than the other, blend over the original color with that first, and you always end with white so that you have a beautiful highlight. And also, food is very light in color, especially a vanilla cupcake. Dark to medium to light creates a gradient, and we will repeat these steps to create a variety of different colors. For chocolate, I like to use the same dark brown, and then I blend and mix with my burnt sienna or my red brown. Notice how it's not two blocks of color, but the brown bleeds into the red brown. Notice how dominant the white is, so the key is to get that middle color back in there. One thing I see students do is just mix all three colors together, and that's gonna create kind of an awkward gray. You wanna keep the brown pure at the end, and you wanna keep the lighter white not touching that darker brown at the end. Repeating this concept, find any dark, medium, or light version of one color or one color family to create a gradient. So for example, I'm using dark pink, light pink, and white. Looking in your pack of oil pastels, you can create any number of gradient mixes following that same concept. Now that you get the idea, let's speed things up a little bit, experimenting with this idea of dark and light versions of a color with white at the end to create fantastic gradients that you have options for in your oil pastel artwork. To make something look even more 3D, you can use more than just three colors. For this one, I'm using red, dark orange, light orange, yellow, and white. So five colors total to create a gradient with an even wider range of values. I often have students ask me, well, what about vanilla because it's just white? And remember, nothing's just one color. So your two best options for that is to start with a lighter blue and then use a dominant with white, or you can start with that yellow ochre, that tan color, to create your more warm shadow. Either looks real enough. I want to try doing a pink where red is the base, so I'm gonna repeat that pink that I made before, replacing the darkest pink with red so it has more variety of value. Time to put that practice to work, and I'm going to use my first gradient to create a vanilla cupcake. With your darkest value, which is your brown, you will outline everything that you drew in pencil. So those lines that I taught you how to draw at the beginning, just outline thick with your brown. The accordion lines, the lines at the bottom and top of your cupcake, and anything that is not your icing. Now is the good job, sweetheart step. And you're gonna pretend like it's a coloring book and you just fill everything else in with the middle part of your gradient, which is this tan or yellow ochre. Keep in mind, you do wanna blend the brown into the yellow and you don't wanna keep it just liney. So don't be afraid to smush that brown in there. We will go back and make sure your lines are crisp, but just like you did with your gradient, the brown and the tan shouldn't be separate from each other. Oil pastels can be messy and, well, oily, so I always keep a scrap piece of paper to rest under my palm as I draw and also to clean off my oil pastel since I'm smushing and blending so many colors together. Going back with your brown, crisp up those lines that you want to really stand out as brown if you lost anything when blending. The last step is adding white, and that's when the magic really happens. Your cake will start to look very three-dimensional and you're going to blend in the center part of each section. So not blending on the brown, you're gonna blend on the yellow tan to make it have a highlight, and it's gonna start to really pop and look three-dimensional. Cleaning your white is going to be very important because you will be going over so many colors with it that it will pick up colors that you've blended before. Now it's time for icing, and I'm doing a cherry cupcake, so I'm going to choose my red, pink, and white gradient. Just like with the cake section, you will start with your darkest color first, and you're going to outline each of the three parts of your icing. Then take your middle color, and for me it's pink, and fill it in completely, blending into that first color so it's not outlined, but it flows from dark to light. Fill it all the way in, even though we will be putting white on top of this. Last, it's time to add white to really make the icing look three-dimensional. Make sure it's clean and blend in the middle section of each of the three sections of your icing. I always go back to my middle color and soften the edges a little bit so it has a nice flow of dark to light and really follows a smooth gradient. Once it's blended, I layer a second white highlight so there's an area that really pops and stands out. A highlight is the lightest part of an object that light reflects, and food, especially icing, can be really shiny. Now for a shadow. I don't want this to look like a flying space cupcake, even though that sounds kind of cool. And I'm going to make a beautiful dark blue and light blue shadow inspired by one of my favorite artists, Wayne Thiebaud. You could use black and gray if you find the blue too unrealistic, but I personally prefer the vibrant shadow inspired by one of my favorite artists. You do not have to add white with this because it's a shadow and there's no highlight. Decorating your cupcake is one of the most fun parts of this artwork. Sprinkles, icing drizzles, Oreos, strawberries, a cherry on top, really anything you can think of you can add as decoration. There's just one simple rule to follow. Always add a highlight and add a gradient when you can. With my icing drizzle, I'm adding black as a base to give it a dark shadow. So this isn't a gradient that I practice, but if you want to do a darker chocolate like Devil's Food Cake, your gradient would be black, brown, and white. So try it out, and I'm doing that just so that the black really stands out from the icing of my cupcake. Now I'm adding my white, and notice it looks a little weird at first. So when working in a small area, blending with an edge of your oil pastel is going to be important. I wanted to add one more finishing touch, you know, the cherry on top of this work of art. And so I'm using my pencil to map out my cherry. I have tried this before and I didn't like how the cherry looked, so this time I drew it in with the pencil first. Following the same rules, I fill it all in with red, and my gradient for this is a dark blue on the bottom. I'm going to add the blue and then blend it with the red to fill it in. If you want to see a detailed tutorial on how to draw a cherry with oil pastels, check out the link above. I have a full-length tutorial all about that. Just keep in mind, you always want to highlight, your base color fills in everything else, and you do include the darkest color down at the bottom. I'm adding a really simple brown stem to finish my cherry. And remember, you can put whatever you want on top of your cupcake. To really call this finished, I go back with white to enhance my highlight. Oil pastels do dry over time, and sometimes I do this the next day, so my highlight really blings or stands out. With a critical eye, I noticed that my icing drizzle was a little messy and sloppy. So going back with my shadow, my black, or the darkest part of my gradient to crisp up those edges, makes me feel like this work of art is almost finished. Done! And now I desperately want a cupcake. I'm going to repeat all these same steps again, but quicker so that you can see me do a chocolate cupcake. Instead of my blue construction paper, I am using a marbleized paper I made with shaving cream and watercolor. Click the link above and I will show you step by step how to do that. It's such a fun and easy way to enhance your artworks is to have decorative paper underneath them. There is absolutely nothing different about the technique I'm showing you, just the colors that I'm choosing. This time I'm going for a chocolate cake, and just like before, outline with your darkest color in your gradient, which is still the dark brown. Fill it in with your lighter brown, just like you saw me do before. If you want like a really dark chocolate, you know, devil's food cake, that sort of thing, do black, dark brown, and white, and that should give you that really dark effect. For my icing, I'm doing the galaxy effect, black, purple, and white, of course, in the middle. Blending is key, so if it looks too outliney, always go back and forth with your dark and light colors until you have a wonderful blend. For decoration, I am adding a variety of sprinkles that fit into my galaxy concept and color scheme. Remember the rule, always add a highlight and add a gradient when you can. Adding a gradient on every single sprinkle would be a little intense. So if you add 15 sprinkles, just add 15 highlights. And it is tricky to get in there with the white, especially if it's used like mine. I know that seems like a lot of tedious work, but it goes fast, I promise. And you don't want flat sprinkles when you put so much effort into making a three-dimensional looking cupcake. The final step, as always, is looking for touch-ups and adding white so that you have really dynamic values and you have highlights that pop. Well, there it is, everything I know about oil pastel blending and drawing cupcakes. If you love working with oil pastels, check out my other tutorials, how to draw cherries, how to draw a donut, how to draw a jelly donut. You can see I'm obsessed with food. And visit my website, thatartteacher.com, if you're a teacher, to get my full lesson plans, student examples, and art history warm-ups.